Hey guys, tools of the trade, stringers. You need to be able to put your fish on a stringer and keep them fresh, and you can fish for a couple more hours. And just using these stringers, you essentially just keep your fish in the water. So I use two type of stringers in my bag. I have the rope nylon kind. It has a spike and a ring, and then I also use this kind, which we also recommend on our website. Anyway, this is the standard stringer. It comes in a spike with one end and a ring on another. So it's quite simple. You can string this through the gill, okay, and out the mouth of the fish and put the ring through, and then essentially just cinch it up. Okay, I call this my one and done stringer. Now you can, if you catch any more fish after that, you can essentially just keep on stringing it through the gill, out through the mouth, and then just stack them. Okay, remember one stringer, you can have your limit per species. And it's important you follow that rule to make sure that everybody's in compliance. I believe it's here in California, it's 5 species per stringer per person. Now the other stringer that I use is this kind. This kind actually comes with these 3 hooks, latchable hooks, okay? And this is actually a 15 footer, maybe even longer cord. It's like a power cord, and it's got a carabiner on one end, so you can just strap that onto your chair or to a rod holder or to the actual railings of a pier or a dock. But this is quite simple to use. Okay, the shape of it allows the fish to continue breathing in the water when it's in the water. This has a spring coil, okay, that you can spin and it'll release the hook itself. So you can put this through the mouth, okay, through the mouth of the fish, out through the gill, secure it, and then latch it. That's how you do it. And then you just keep on loading it up. Hopefully you'll catch fish. That's pretty much it on how to use a stringer. Good luck fishing.